I'm always on my grind. My money will incline. My mother told me rhyme, cause her sun is gonna shine. I'm always on my grind.
This is the Real Lil Show, and we are back on the show, and we got our grind report, famously done by Mel from WYGL. Let's get it.
Oh, wow. What's going on, you guys? So, for the grind report, we have the wonderful and talented Jennifer Lopez. And
the beautiful. Don't forget beautiful. Lie. The beautiful.
Yeah, she's bad.
Oh, she's bad. Bad. Exactly.
I saw Hustlers,
though. Don't tell me about it. Remember that movie? What was it? The Girl Next Hustlers? Door? What was it? It was like a scary movie, but
a neighbor movie.
Yeah, The Girl Next Door. You feel me? Oh my gosh. That scene, brother, I'm not even gonna lie. That one scene had me like, maybe it's Maybelline. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm not even gonna lie. But go ahead.
But yeah, so we have, of course, the talented and wonderful Jennifer Lopez and Hips Don't Lie singer Shakira is set to perform in the Super Bowl come February 2020. Now, this is honestly, I don't know if it's a shocker to me. I really don't know how I should react to this. I feel like at this point, I'm tired of like canceling the NFL because people still be up every Sunday. Every Sunday night, people still be out there supporting football and stuff like that in the NFL. So at this point, I don't know if, you know, people will find this a problem, but maybe this is probably what we need, is like the set to break it. And I don't know, for the past couple of years, I don't think there has been any like women artists like performing, but before, after Beyonce.
How do y'all like this lineup?
I mean, I think it would be a fun performance. I mean, I ain't gonna hold you. I think I will watch it because I'm like, yo, it's J-Lo. It's Shakira, like, come on.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of
throwbacks.
I mean,
yeah, J-Lo
still makes music. Shakira, I think, makes music.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that.
It's just gonna be fun to watch the throwbacks. Like, when Justin Timberlake, you know, performed last year, it was just his throwbacks, you know?
Yeah.
His new music nobody really listened to.
Remember that incident with, since you brought up Justin Timberlake, when Justin Timberlake performed with
Janet Jackson
and her yes. thing started showing.
I was watching
that. My gosh.
I was watching that.
She he gave the world a look that they would never forget, and they like.
But then they said, we was in class and he was talking about the case where she was just like a malfunction. Like, she didn't really. I mean,
but she took a lot of flack for that.
Yeah.
And it wasn't even her fault.
It wasn't.
She took the most flack. JT was good. JT.
Bro, she didn't design her outfit. She put it on, but she didn't design the outfit. She didn't rip it off.
She didn't know he was going to do that.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Nah. You feel me? And then she took the most. People was calling her this. Like,
what was he thinking?
I thought it was an accident.
It was an accident. He didn't do it on purpose. But, you know, when the adrenaline pumping, you feel me?
You just act. She acted fast, though. Because then she covered it like mad fast.
Of course. You feel the air. You feel the air. Of course. You feel me?
You got to do what you got to do.
But that's a fact. I mean, me personally, I like this lineup. I'm not even going to lie. I do. But at the same time, man, it's not the point, man. A lot of people seem to forget that it shows you that the NFL is getting their money's worth when it comes to Jay-Z and that partnership. Now, a lot of people don't like that partnership. Some people do. I'm one of those people that don't like that partnership. Why? Because Colin Kaepernick was taking a knee, and a lot of people was not performing. Cardi B turned down the performance. Rihanna turned down the performance. Jay-Z himself told people to turn down performances with the NFL, and told people like Jermaine Dupri that, listen, since Colin Kaepernick is taking a knee, you don't need to be, ladies and gentlemen. So, honestly, the fact that Jay-Z's working with them now, the NFL's getting their money's worth, people was waiting for Jay-Z to do something, to make some type of change that I don't even think he'd be able to make. Because all the change I see is with the news that Mel just said on her ground report, that J-Lo and dad going, Shakira, oh baby, when you talk like that.
I really think it's gonna be a fun performance.
Yeah.
I just don't know how to, like, I'm not gonna say I don't know how to say because they're like Latina women, but I'm just like, I just feel like I think I'm at the point where it's, I don't want to say I'm tired, but it's like so much stuff that goes on behind the scenes that I don't know about, and that's what's making me iffy still about this situation.
You know, me personally, I like the fact that we're getting good performances, you feel me? And that, to some degree, we gotta be thankful for that, because I mean, those terrible halftime shows, I mean, last year I was typing a paper. I was like, brother, please, okay? I don't want to see Big Boy come out in 5 seconds tip his hat and go away.
You didn't like Travis's part?
I mean, I didn't like it.
Perform.
Travis and Maroon 5.
I didn't really.
The last person I saw was Beyonce. Let me beat you.